Your new home is a blank slate. When it comes to decorating, where do you start? We'll go room by room to make it easy, with great ideas in every room. The kitchen, living areas, the owner's suite, and your flex room. I'm Angela Niesel, the National Director of Design at Pulte Group. I manage a large team of designers who design over 400 homes a year. I've been with Pulte for over 14 years, and during that time, we've made a science out of simplified design. We can show you how to design step by step and room by room to make sure you end up with a home you love. First, decide what you want from your kitchen so you can personalize it. Do you want your kitchen to be the main attraction at every party? A culinary mecca? A central hangout? Take our Kitchenology quiz on Pulte.com to help. Once you've determined your kitchen usage, it's time to choose your finishes and features. Start by selecting foundational items like your cabinet finish and door style. Then select your countertop and backsplash. Your kitchen is the largest statement maker in the home. When you feel comfortable about your kitchen's palette, you can move on to selecting the flooring to complement it. The lighting and kitchen faucets should be the last items you choose. New trends are leaning towards mixed metals, so feel free to get creative. Keep in mind that when implementing the mixed metal feel, up to two contrasting metals in one space will provide balance and interest. If you love the look of stainless faucets and cabinet hardware, but also love the bold impact matte black adds to the lighting element, go for it. Talk to one of our design experts. We can help you choose finishes to really pull a room together. When decorating a space, start with the largest elements that make the most impact. Beginning with the larger statement pieces ensures you're off to the right start from a style and scale standpoint. If your foundation is strong, everything you add to the space will only enhance it. It will make it more cohesive. For example, invest in a nice sofa that is both visually pleasing and comfortable. Or for a dining room, invest in the dining chairs and lighting, since they surround the table and set the tone for the room. When purchasing furniture and larger items, it's important to understand the scale of your room and how to lay out your space to meet your particular needs. Our floor plans are designed with furniture scale in mind. We also have online tools to help you plan where your furniture will go. Knowing which wall the TV will be placed on will help determine your furniture placement. Keep in mind, you ideally want 3 feet of walk space around your furniture arrangement if it's not grounded against a wall. This will help guide your furniture selection and layout. This is a good time to talk about area rugs. Here are a few rules of thumb. Larger rugs are better. Choose the size that allows all of your furniture to fit on the rug. A common size for a living room or large dining room is 8 by 10 feet, but it can vary. If you choose a smaller rug for your living room, keep your rug large enough that you have the front feet of your furniture on the rug. In the bedroom, either opt for runners that run along the side of your bed or choose a rug that's big enough to fit under your bed but peeks out on the sides and foot of the bed. You spend a lot of time in your owner's suite. It's where you feel the most comfortable. Here are some ways to help make that happen. Again, make each decision in manageable pieces. Identify which wall will be the focal wall first. This will determine how to lay out the room. As you walk into the owner's suite, the focal wall is typically the first wall you see. When selecting furniture for this space, look for ways to add interest and visual contrast. Keep your nightstands one color and contrast your dresser or headboard with a different finish or element. Most Pulte homes offer a flex room, a spare room you can use however you want. Your flex room can be anything, and it can evolve over time based on changing needs and growing families. Identify how you want this room to function. Will this be a multi-purpose space for you and the kids? Will it be a more formal office? Do you have something else in mind? Maybe a playroom, guest room, or music room? Once you've had a chance to live in your home for a while and know how you'll be using the room, think about your storage. If the space is intended for play, Consider storage with solid doors so clutter can be hidden. If you want to create an office retreat, use open storage to display accessories and photos. Those are just some rules of thumb when it comes to designing your house and making it a home. We have trained experts in our design centers who can walk you through all of your options and help you make choices based on your taste.